Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, we are going to talk all about IoT based smart patient production monitor with ESP8266 and sending critical medical alerts to the hospital management and patient caretakers. This project truly designed for the people whose production levels need to be monitored 24/7 continuously. For example, COVID patients or any other patients who are on the ventilator. This project continuously monitors particular person's blood oxygen levels and then logs them into the Ubidots platform. And also it will send critical medical alerts to the hospital management and patient caretakers whenever the blood oxygen levels goes below the threshold with the help of Ubidots event and alerts feature. I'm so excited about this project to share with you. So without wasting much time, let's dive into the episode. Wait. Before jumping into the episode, let me thank my favorite PCB manufacturer, PCBWay.com, for sponsoring this video.
This video is sponsored by PCBWay.com. PCBWay is the one of the best PCB manufacturers in the current industry. PCBWay is offering services like PCB prototyping, assembly stencil, PCB assembly, flexible PCBs, and advanced PCBs. At PCBWay.com, we can get 10 pieces of 2-layer PCBs at just $5 with 24 hours build time. The best part of PCBWay is the instant quote feature. Just enter the PCB size, choose quantity, layers and thickness. That's it. We will get the instant quote. Place the order by clicking on save to cart.
Required components: breadboard, ESP8266 module, MAX30100 pulse oximeter sensor, 4.7 kΩ resistors, and connecting wires. Here is the circuit diagram for IoT based smart patient blood oxygen meter with ESP8266 module. Connect the MAX30100 sensor module with ESP8266 and add two pull-up resistors to the SDA and SCL data lines of the sensors as shown in the circuit diagram. Let's create a device in Ubidots platform for our solution. Visit ubidots.com. Go to Dashboard. Click on Devices. Create a new device. Select a blank device. Enter the name for the device, then click on the green tick mark to create the device. That's it. The device is successfully created. Let's move to the programming part. Here is the code for IoT-based smart patient blood oxygen meter with ESP8266 module. This code will be available on the project page, which is mentioned in the description below. I assume you already know about installing ESP8266 add-on and required libraries for the project on the Arduino IDE. If you are following my previous videos, you will know about it. So I am skipping this part. If you don't know about, you can still learn from the above attached I button. To make this code work with our Ubidots device, we need to provide the following details. Provide Wi-Fi SSID and password for internet connection. Then provide the Ubidots token. We can get this from the Ubidot itself. Go to API credentials, copy this token and paste it over here. Then enter the device label which we have created on the Ubidots earlier. Now enter the variable labels and MQTT client name on your wish. Or you can leave the same because that doesn't make any difference. Now this code is ready to upload to the ESP8266 module. Connect the ESP8266 module with laptop. Check the uploading configurations like board, NodeMCU 1.0, ESP12A module, uploading speed and select the right port. If everything is okay, upload it. While compiling in progress, put the ESP8266 in programming board by pressing the reset button while holding the flash button, and then release it. After successful uploading, open serial monitor. On the serial monitor, we can see our ESP8266 successfully connected to the programmed Wi-Fi and allocated with IP address. Then initiated MQTT connection with Ubidots cloud and connected to it. Then it started publishing heart rate and percentage of oxygen saturation, which is SpO2 data, to the Ubidots platform. Gently place your finger on the oximeter and you can see the live data on the serial monitor. Do not press your finger hardly, that will lead to inaccurate data. Now go to the Ubidots and reload it. You can see the last activity in few seconds, which means our pulse oximeter is communicating with Ubidots. The best part of the Ubidots is if it receives the data from any module, it will automatically create those variables and start storing data for us. Here you can see the same variables are created automatically. Currently, we are receiving and storing the data on the Ubidots. Now let's visualize the same data. For that, choose dashboard from the data drop-down menu. Click on add new widget. You will be prompted with bunch of data visualization options. Choose one among them. I will use a metric to display the heart rate. Click on add variables. Then select the device oximeter. And then select the variable heart rate. Add a name for the metric. Keep the rest of the options default. Later create it. After creating, you can see the live data on the dashboard. Now let's repeat the same process for SpO2. For SpO2, I would like to choose the gaze option to visualize it. For SpO2, I would like to add color logic to differentiate the safe or critical blood oxygen levels. If the blood oxygen levels are 95% or above, they are said to be safe. Below 95% are critical. So I will select green color if the oxygen levels are greater than 95% and red color if the oxygen levels are lesser than 95%. Then click on accept. After creating, you can see the live data in the green color on the gauge because it is greater than 95%. If that value is less than 95%, you can see that in the red color. To demonstrate, I am moving the finger to create fake abnormality in the readings. So, it perfectly worked. You can see the data in red color. Now, let's move to the most important part of the episode, creating alerts when abnormal blood oxygen levels is noticed. Ubidots supports integrated events to allow us to send alerts and notifications to those who need to know when they need to know. In our case, the hospital management and the caretaker of the patient should know whenever the blood oxygen levels are go down. So let's configure it now. Due to long length of the video, I have divided this whole video into two parts. So, configurations of this event alerts will be discussed in the next episode. You can find the link for that video in the top right corner. See you there. Bye-bye.